Hello, everybody. This is Kaylana, aka the Blessed Driver, and today I'm going to do a brief vlog on how to slowly work your way out of the rideshare delivery and the app-based business. Now, I'm not saying actually quit or anything like that, but I'm just going to just kind of share with you guys how to slowly work your way out into doing what you really want to do, especially for those of us that have our own business. So, get my Afro puff. Anyway, so I've been thinking about some things, and so I've noticed that the more people that these companies hire, sometimes the less work there is for you. And especially like with Uber and with Lyft and with Instacart, Grubhub, so many of these companies, when they first launched, it's like there's so much work to do. You make great money. Not that you don't do now, but it's like the more people they hire, the less money you make sometimes. And that's not to discourage you guys from applying or anything like that. But basically, there's so many things that are going on at this time. And so I know it can be kind of frustrating when you're really trying to make some money, or there's not enough hours, or whatever the case may be. But despite of all of that, I just want to just share with you on some ways that you can kind of slowly work your way out of this type of business, is exactly what I'm going to be doing eventually, into either starting your own business or maybe working for another company, like 9 to 5 type of deal. So it's going to be totally up to you. The first thing you want to do is create a plan. Like, you have to have a plan. You have to have something down in writing, not just think about it, but something in writing where you can always go back and look at and meditate on. And so to basically also track your steps on how to proceed and how to be successful, especially with excuse me, starting your own business and things like that. Because think about it, when you start a business, of course you need what? A business plan. First thing you do is, like I said, is to create a plan. Okay, what are your short-term goals? What are your long-term goals? Like, how do you plan, like, on starting? How long do you plan on driving or delivering or whatever it is that you're doing, and things like that. And so that's the first thing you do is, okay, say, you know what, I want to save X amount of dollars in X amount of time. That's something you definitely need to work on. And I know it might be hard, especially for you single parents, for us single parents rather, or maybe you have, or maybe you are married or whatever the case may be, and you just can't seem to save enough money because going to bills, going to the kids, going to college education, going to tuition, car repairs, rent, mortgage, like whatever. Start with the plan, okay? Start with what you want to do, your goals, and work on it from there. The next thing is to basically reach out to other people that do what you do. For instance, if you are driving for Uber or for Lyft or for delivering for Caviar, Postmates, Instacart, like whatever it is, make sure that it's good to connect with other people in the industry so they can give you some tips and tricks on how they were able to do better for themselves, and how they were able to get out, and how they were able to, start something new. Because I'm telling you, a lot of people that do this, they don't stay in it for the long haul. And they have better jobs, they have their own business and stuff like that. So that is a great way to be able to, sorry if I'm saying too much. That is a great way to be able to, kind of launch your own thing and be able to kind of squeeze your way out of this particular industry. Because I'm telling you, it's kind of crazy sometimes when, you're so busy and then all of a sudden you're not. And that's okay. And so, like I said, connect with other people. Either you can go on Facebook groups, you can go on different groups online, you can just connect. Just basically connection, because you might end up speaking with somebody who has great ideas on how they were able to succeed outside of driving, outside of delivering, and things like that. So that's great. Another way, number three, to be able to be successful and how to slowly work your way out of these industries is definitely save money. Save your money. And I'm also speaking to myself, make sure that you're saving your money. And I know you got car insurance, you got to pay if you have a car payment. At that, you got your rent, you got your mortgage, you got lights, of course, your cell phone bill. If you have kids, you got to pay, you have to buy clothes, of course, you got to buy food. There's so many things you have to do. And I'm not just talking about the daily necessities or the monthly necessities, but I'm also talking about things that you really don't need. Like for me, I like to eat. And For me, I'm low maintenance when it comes to some stuff. Like some women, they love to get their hair and their nails done, and there's nothing wrong with that. Some women, they like to buy a whole bunch of makeup, things like that. But I mean, I don't really do all that. I like to eat. Like I will go to Whole Foods or something, and I will spend like $30 on food, you know. And sometimes it'll sit there. But I'm talking about the buffet, you know, like the little buffet aisle that they have in there, you know, silly stuff, you know. And so, make sure that you are saving your money. Like even if it's $10, $15, like there is a Instacart shopper that I know. Her and I are very close. And she called me the other day and she was like, you know, she just called me out the blue. And she began to tell me that she saved X amount of dollars over X amount of time. I'm like, you save that much? And she just doesn't spend it. And she goes, you know, I thought about something. Like, you know, going to Starbucks and this place and that place. And, you know, I know how I spend on groceries. And she's a single mom too. And so she began to give me information. And I was thinking to myself, you know what? I've been trying to find ways to do that. And also, just a sidetrack real quick, you know, I'm a filmmaker and I'm also a photographer, so it's like I have not made a film in a couple of years. And there's a film that I have made, but I have not actually I have not released it yet because I had some technical difficulties with my software. But anyway, long story short, I have a batch from Instacart now. But anyway, long story short, I just want to go ahead and let you guys know that is a way to kind of get your way out of, you know, the industry is to connect. Now, the fourth thing I'm going to say real quick because I have to go, this is gonna there is going to be a part two, is also making sure that you have your ducks in a row, meaning like you're focused, you're not being distracted. That's another thing how sometimes we kind of get off track is don't be so busy doing this to where you're not making a plan to try to get out. You know, meaning like you're always working, working, working. You're not saving money. You're not making a plan. Just stay focused and don't get distracted by what other people are saying about the industry, even though it might be true. Don't get so consumed with what other people are saying in some of these Facebook groups or some of these social media groups. Just stay focused. Stay focused and stay on your grind. Save your money. Connect with those who are going to help and encourage you. Just continue to do what you do. And there will be a part two because I have to go. There will be a part two. I'm going to share with you guys on how to make money, how to save it, and also ways that you can be able to slowly weasel your way out of, not weasel, I want to say weasel, but you know, slowly move your way out of these industries to be able to work for yourself. Because I know times are hard. You got to do what you got to do. I got to do what I got to do. We totally understand. So there will be a part two. Also, I do have a group now. Actually, I had a group on there months and months ago, but I haven't really focused on it. But I do have a Facebook group for rideshare drivers, delivery drivers, you know, app-based gigs. You know, it's the link is down there at the bottom. It's on Facebook. Please feel free to join. Also, if you are in Florida, I do have a separate group for that for Florida Instacart shoppers as well. So I have a worldwide group. I have a couple of groups. So go ahead and just click down there and just search which group you want to join for everybody. Now, I don't want you guys getting into groups cussing and acting crazy. It's just for support, encouragement, things like that. So I gotta run. I gotta get out of here, guys. There will be a part two. So like I said, like, comment, subscribe. If you have any questions, shoot me an email. I'll talk to you guys later. God bless you. Peace.